Hello guys, today we are going to discuss about the historical data logging in the Intouch, Wonderware Intouch, and you can go to the Wonderware Intouch here. And I'm going to create a new application and click next and type my application name as historical logging. Okay, next, finish, and I got the new Intouch application here. Double click and open it. Okay, just create a new window, just give any name, click OK. And here we are going to take the historical trend data from here on the wizards. First, I'm going to put a slider for the input. Here I can see the sliders. Just put my slider here, and I just taken the historical trends from the wizards here. This is the trends. Here you can see the trends, and here you can see the historical trend. Okay, double click on it and place here. Then just a bit drag to here. Then we need some more things to some more equipments to some more add-ons for the historical trends. So we go to the trends, and here you can see the trend zoom in or zoom out panel. So double click on, and I'm placing here. This is the panel which is helping to zoom in or zoom out the historical trend, because we are using the values for logging for days. So we have to zoom in or zoom out to analyze the values. And go to wizards, trends. Here you can see the trend zoom panel, the trend pen legend. This is the pen they are going to draw for the historical data logging. So double click and place. So first we have to configure the slider. So as usual, it is a normal IO integer. So double click on it. Just given my tag name as SL slider. Okay, and define SL, and the SL, the type of memory is IO integer. Click OK. And access name as Galaxy. Here you can see use the tag name as item name. Click on it, and you can see the log data here. Okay, and can click on the log data. I just check on the log data and save it, close it. My slider is configured. Then go to the trend, double click on it. You can give the historical trend as I'm going to give X, and the pen scale as Y. You have to give the same historical trend name and pen scale for the zoom panel and the tag name pen. And you can see the values, timers and pens. You can enter the pen as the slider name, the tag name for the slider SL. My color will be green. They have 8 different pens, so that I can give 8 different inputs and log inputs, and click OK. OK, and just configure the zoom in panel. Double click as same as the previous X. The pen is Y. Click OK, and the pen legend. Save here, X, Y, over, and okay. Just to go to check once more. Okay, and okay. Okay, and we have to enable one more thing. From the special, go to special, configure the historical logging. Here is the historical logging. And you have to check the enable historical logging. Keep data logging for one day. I just give one and click OK. Okay, and let's go to the runtime. Here you can see the runtime window, and I'm going to click on the next. Here you can see our data is logging here. This is a small scale, we cannot see it very properly, so I'm going to give some values, give some random values, moving my slider up and down very frequently so that we can get a slight output or the slight difference in the slight change in the curve. That is my historical logging. That is a huge data logging, that is why it is very small. And let's check it. So I just given some random values using my slider by moving it up and down. I just giving my random values and click here. Yeah, I just taken zoom, specify zoom by dragging that to time base here and zoom in. Okay, and go once again. Okay, yeah, here we got the historical logging. Here you can zoom it, zoom in, you can see the historical trend that is logged. Specified zooming, zoom in, here you can see the change in the slider. So I'm specifying it, the changing the range, the slider only have the 0 to 100 range. Okay, I'll log input the specified range of the historical data logging is -37,000 to +37,000. It is a wide range, so we cannot give the specified range. So I'm just decreasing the range of the analysis. That's why it is in the small manner. Yeah, this is my change in the input. That is the historical logging. Thank you.